The future freeze effect, as it's being called on some forums now, is when a person moves into a still of themselves in the future, as you see here, my son Eddie running over, jumping over these chairs. Now, some people will say, oh, that's easy to do. I can export a movie, I can export a still, I can go into Pixelmator, Photoshop, whatever, Motion After Effects to go back into it. It's just a lot of work. So what I'm going to do is show you how to do it all right inside of Final Cut Pro, real quick and real easy, using SliceX and TrackX from CoreMelt, two absolute must-have plugins. Here we are in Final Cut Pro, and here's my original clip. Okay. First thing I'm going to do, so I'm going to turn on and make sure snapping is turned on. It's this little button over here. Mid shortcut is in. We're going to need that. Then I'm going to hit S, turn on my skimmer. I only have the skimmer on when I need it. Otherwise, I turn it off. It can be a pain. But when you need it, it's great. I'm going to come here to about 130. Click, get my playhead there. Hit M, make a marker. And I'm going to skim down here. And I'm making markers where I want my stills to be. These markers are going to help us out a great deal. Get up here where he goes, wah, flying through the air. And we'll come to about 315 is a good round number, good spot. Click, M, make a marker. Turn off my skimmer. Okay, I'm going to use Control with the semicolon and apostrophe keys to get between my markers. I'll come to the first marker. And there's a problem here. If I want to make a still, if I do it directly from the timeline, in the edit menu, there is this add freeze frame. It is option F. So if I do an option F, oh, look what it does. It gives me a freeze frame, but it splits it. It doesn't insert edit with the freeze frame. That's not what I want to do. I want to make it a connected clip. I can right click and I come down here to reveal in browser. Shortcut is shift F. So I'm going to do a shift F. It'll take me to the master clip in the browser on that frame. Now when I go to the edit menu, that command has changed. Same keyboard shortcut, option F, but now it's connect freeze frame, and it connects a freeze frame at that spot. I'm going to pull this freeze frame to the beginning, and I'm going to trim it there to that marker. Now a little quirky thing about Final Cut, I need this to be one frame longer than the marker. So I'm going to highlight it, Control D, and right here in the dashboard, 130, I'll type in 131, hit enter. Now it's one frame longer. Control semicolon to my next marker, Shift F, and again, I'm going to do an option F, connects me. I'm going to pull it down here, butt it up against that one, and I'll just trim that up to that marker, select it, again, Control D, it's 144, so I'll type in 145, and boom, it's one frame longer. Hit my home key, Shift Z, fit to window. Now I'm ready to go to work. First thing I've got to do is I've got my two stills, and I did not have to leave Final Cut for that. Now I'm going to mask my stills out. On the first one, so I'm going to zoom in. I think I'm going to go about 200%. And I'm going to go up here and I'll grab my toolbar, drag my toolbar down so I can see this. Now I can draw my mask. Now, there's an issue with CoreMelt right now. You can't use the Final Cut native mask effect and have it track with TrackX. You have to use the SliceX mask. So I'll come to Command 5, open my effects here. I'll come down to C2 Slice X. I'm going to take this shape mask layer effect and put it on that clip. So now what I'll do is I've got a mask. I've got to mask my buddy out here. I'm going to come and click and take this little polygon tool, and I'm going to rough in just something real rough here. I'm not going to spend a lot of time perfecting it, but if you do something like this and you really need it to look realistic, if you really need perfection, you're going to spend a whole lot more time than I am creating a really good quality, precise mask. That's just going to be part of any effects work, is doing, spending time making very laborious, precise, quality masks. Now, the reason I'm going in between his knees and his feet here is because when the video comes up and this front leg here comes up, I want it to come behind. I want to see it move behind here. So if I just went from this foot, that would block it off and his right leg would disappear for a moment. Now, up here, I can kind of cheat because I only need the mask to, and I need to bring shape softness down to zero. I only need it to be up against his backside here because that's where he's running into. Once he hits this, it doesn't matter, as you'll see in just a moment. So that's done. Now that that's done, I'm going to select this and hit V, as in Victor, to mute it. Okay, that's done. That's all I need to do with that. Now, hit my down arrow key and come up to my next clip here. Move this over. I'm going to zoom out to about 100% here. Yeah, that's good enough. Again, put the shape mask layer on here. This little polygon tool. And I'll rough this in. Now, there's a difference with this one that I'll show you after I throw this real quickie shape mask on here. Again, I'm just roughing this in to save time, just to show you how this works. Now, I need to be careful with this because I purposefully shot with auto iris turned on. So I moved from a shaded area to a not so shaded area. And even with this sloppy mask going on, it's going to show up. Okay, and bring shape softness down to zero. And I will hit V and mute that clip. And come back up here and fit to window. So now, let me skim through here so you can see. Notice in the beginning here how dark this grass is. Well, as I come, the iris changed room right there. Notice how light this grass is right there. Watch, it goes darker, goes lighter. And I'll show you a really exaggerated thing about that. But point is, this is an issue that will come up in any effects shot that you do. Anything that's green screen, live action, clean plate. Be very careful not to set anything to automatic when you do these shots. Plan them out very well. Pay close attention to lighting. I'll go ahead and give myself more timeline room, which is what I need now. Now I'm going to come to the generators, to my C2 TrackX collection, and I'm going to use the simple tracker. And here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to select this muted clip. My playhead is on it, so I'll hit X. And it is now a range, not just a selection, but a range. Because if I select the simple tracker and hit Q to make it a connected clip, not only is it a connected clip, it is that exact same range. Now, I'll close that up because I'm done. I'm going to grab this since I need two copies, and I'm going to hold down the Option key and drag it on top of itself. And I'm even going to make these a little thinner so you can see easier. This bottom one I'm actually going to drag all the way out. It needs to come out to the end of the second clip just for organization. And for now, I'm going to go ahead and mute that. Now, the tracker here is going to track. It's going to look at whatever the first visible clip is below it. Both of these are invisible, so I don't have to So we're good. Hit home, get back to my home key. I'm gonna hit my polygon tool, and I need to track an object, and this chair is where that still is gonna be stuck to, so I'm going to track this chair. I'm gonna give it a little space around the chair, not get too close to the chair, because Eddie actually runs up onto the chair in front of it, and I don't want it to, I want it to still have enough data there to track. So now I'll just click the track forward button, and it tracks very quickly. Done. All right. So now what I'll do is, with this tracker selected in the generator section of the inspector, I'll click the insert layer image well. Come down here. I'm going to mouse over my still image. Click a frame. Select apply clip. And I'll need to change my scale offset to 1. So now I have my playhead on that marker with this tracker. I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to zoom in 200%. Let me get up over here so I can see Eddie. And I'm going to start playing with my XY offsets. Now, I can use these sliders, but I find they're not nearly accurate enough. They jump too much. So I like to just double click and drag on the numeric field. I can get much more precise with my mouse with that. Now, to line these up properly, let's go to the video tab and let's set opacity to 50%. Come back over here, generator. Now, I can come in here and now I can get some real precise lining up going on. Make sure both eddies are in the same place in the same frame. Boom, there I am. Do a little fit to window. Command 2 for my timeline, home, and oh, I almost forgot. We have to reset compositing back to 100% opacity. So when I play now, he jumps in himself and keeps going. Now, the second one will do basically the same thing. I'll select this tractor, hit V, turn it back on. And what I'm going to do is hit my up arrow key. I'm going to come to this edit point between these two clips. This is just a convenient place for me to start working. I'm going to move this up out of my way. And I'm going to track this chair, because this second chair is where we want our second still of Eddie to be stuck to. So that's a good place to track. So now I'm going to click the track forward button, and it will track from that spot to the end of the clip. It'll track that chair. Just takes a second or two. And when it is done, hit my up arrow key, come back, and then I'll track backwards. And notice tracking backwards, some of that chair actually kind of goes down and out of the way. So if I was at the beginning of the clip, it would be harder to actually get that tracker around the whole chair. So now the tracking is done. I'm going to come to my, right here, my second marker, where I need to line up the still with the video. Come to the generator tab, click the image well, mouse over my second still, click, apply clip, course, scale offset, make sure it's set to 1. Come to the video tab, change opacity to 50. Then, in the video tab, back in the generator tab. Now, I'm going to just very quickly and very easily line video Eddie up with still image Eddie. Come over here. Sometimes I like to, if I've got it perfectly lined up, sometimes I'll just mess it up on purpose just to make sure. Well, there we go. That looks pretty good. Come back to video, reset that back to 100% opacity. And presto. Now, I'm pretty much done. If I play back, unrendered, okay? Well, that's how you do it. It's quick, it's easy. I hope you learned something, and I hope this was fun. And I look forward to posting my next video tutorial, or my next written tutorial, at www.finalcutx.guru. In the meantime, rock those edits.